Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies like me. And in this video, I'm going to show you the fastest and the easiest way to change the footer copyright credit on any WordPress website, and it doesn't matter what theme you're using. Now, I made a video on this topic about a year ago, and if you look on YouTube, it has over 100,000 views on it, and that's because this is a hot topic. Now, with so many free themes that are available for WordPress and commercial themes, a lot of these free ones, what they do is they make it pretty much impossible to change that footer copyright credit, and you might not want that footer copyright credit, and there's no reason why you have to have it. And after watching this video, you're going to be able to change your footer copyright credit to whatever you want it to be. So I have a simple demo site here, and it's very basic, and I have this footer copyright credit and I don't want it. So I'm going to show you how to change it, and it's going to be super easy and anyone can do it. And in fact, I'm going to do it on several themes. Once we have it set up, it is super easy to do. So let's first log into the back end of our WordPress website. And what I need you to do is go to plugins and click on add new, and I need you to install this plugin that we're going to use to do it. Now, we're not going to be changing any kind of code or installing child themes and copying files and searching through things. It's not going to be that complicated. It's going to be quite easy, and I'm going to walk you through all of it. Now, the name of the plugin that I want you to install is called Real-Time Find and Replace. So just do a quick search for that, click on the install button, and then click on the activate button. Now, what it's going to do is it's going to add a new option here under tools, and it's going to add this new option that says Real-Time Find and Replace. Go ahead and click on that, and it's going to take us to the options for this plugin. Now, what I want to do is kind of explain to you what it does and how it works. Now, this plugin can be used for so many different things, and once you get comfortable with it, you're going to pretty much be blown away at what you can do with this plugin. What it allows you to do is to look at your website and see any bit of text that is on your website and be able to change that text. That it's that simple to use and that powerful. And the thing is you don't even need to know in WordPress where to go to change that bit of text. So first thing, before we get started into using this, let's go ahead and create what we want our new copyright to be. Now, this is a very easy process. I want you to go to Pages, click on All Pages, and then when that opens, go ahead and click on Add New. Now, we're going to actually delete this page. It's just so that we can use it to generate some of the HTML that we might need to maybe make a part of our copyright bold or a different color or italicized or something like that, or maybe a larger font. That's all we're going to use this for. You can go ahead and delete this page afterwards. So let's make sure we're on this visual tab. We don't want to be on the text tab. We want to be on the visual tab. And if you don't have this bottom row of options, just click on this button right here that says toolbar toggle, because we want those options because we might want to apply them to our new copyright. So I'm going to just type out a copyright, and I'm going to just show you how we can edit it. So I'm going to type a copyright like this, and I'm going to put the start year, and I'm going to put the year we are in right now, which is 2016, and then I'm going to maybe put a hyphen, and I will put the name of my website, WPCrafter.com. Okay, so I could just copy this little bit of plain text, but if you want to spruce it up, say we wanted the whole thing bold, we can highlight it all and click on B to make it bold. If we wanted a section of it to be in italics, we can kind of highlight that and click on the button there to make it italics like that. And if there was a section we wanted underlined, we can highlight it and click on this underline option. So you can see I'm able to change it to be whatever I want. And maybe I want this 2013 to be a different color. I'm going to highlight that. And let's choose, say, maybe this color right here. Why not? So the point is, you can make this look however you want. And lastly, we probably want to put a link in for this bit here. So I'm going to highlight it, and I'm going to click on this link option right there, and I'm going to type in a link. Okay, I have my link in right there, and I'm going to click on apply. So we've got this whole bit of copyright here that we've just created. Now, the reason we did this in WordPress is because it's a really easy way to get it formatted the way we want. And then when we click on this text option, we could see WordPress already added this little bit of code to make it work. So now let me show you how the search, find, and replace is going to work. So we need to click on add, and it has this box here. We're going to put some text here that is the copyright as it is right now, and then right here we're going to put what we want it changed to. Now let me show you how to do this. Now I'm in the Safari browser. I'm going to switch to the Firefox web browser because not everybody uses Safari. Most people don't, but everyone has access to Firefox. So here's my existing site. What we need to do is we need to take a look at the source code that generates this and just copy and paste it into the plugin. It might sound more complicated than it is. So in Firefox, I'm going to go and click on the right button on my mouse, and there's this option here that says View Page Source. Now, if you're using Chrome, it's going to have a very similar option. So I'm going to click on View Page Source, and it opens up this bunch of text. Now, whether you know it or not, when someone visits your website gives the web browser what you see right now, this bit of code, and your web browser takes this code and makes the site look like this. So we need to find the little bit of code in here that tells your web browser to show this. And what we're going to do is we're going to search this for this word copyright. So I'm going to go here, and you can do a search on the page. And in Firefox, it pulls up this little bar right here. And I'm going to type in copyright. And as soon as I typed it, it found where it was on the page. So I want to copy this bit of code. So you see how it looks a little different? It has this this right here for that copyright symbol. And there's little bits of code. So we want this whole little bit. So I'm going to highlight all the way across, and this is where it ends, where it says GoDaddy, but I want this bracket slash A, but I don't want the bracket slash div. So I'm going to show you on three or four different themes how easy this is, but this is all that we want, and I'm going to copy it into my clipboard. And then I'm going to go back to the plugin where it says find, and I'm going to paste it in right there. Okay, so this is the bit of code that tells your web browser to show that copyright, and that's all we're after. Okay, so let's go back to where we made that copyright, and I'm going to copy this into my clipboard, and I'm going to paste it where it says replace. So basically this plugin, we're telling it, when you see this code, don't show that code, instead show this code. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and click on update settings. I'm going to go to the front end of the site, and I'm going to refresh the page. So we're going to know it works if this changes. Okay. And I just did a refresh, and there's that new copyright that I made. Now, obviously, you're going to want one that looks more professional. I did this on purpose to show you that you can format this however you want to format it. But there is our new copyright. Now, I'm going to show you how to do this in three other themes. It's going to just take maybe 30 seconds a theme, and then I'm going to tell you some things that you want to be aware of that might break this, okay? So let's just go ahead and right here, I'm not going to save this, so I'm going to go to themes, and I'm going to change my theme. So I'm going to change it to this eShop, which is a very popular theme. I'm going to click on activate. Now when I go to the front end of my site and do a refresh, the copyright has totally changed to what they push in there, and that's this proudly powered by WordPress. So let me go back to Firefox. I'm going to close this. I'm going to do my refresh, and now I need to look at the source and do a search for maybe this word proudly. So I'm going to right click, view page source, and I'm going to pull up the find, and I'm going to type proud. And there it is. So I want to start on this theme right here, and I want to go all the way down to the last bit, which is this themes for WP. And you can see it, themes for WP. So I'm going to copy that into my clipboard. And now I'm going to go back to my find and replace, and I'm going to change this right here to what is in this particular theme, and I'm going to click on update settings. So now when I do a refresh, if it worked, this should change to that silly copyright that I created. And there it is, my silly copyright that I created. Okay, so that's another theme. Let's try with this Max store. Actually, you know what? Let me skip it. You're getting the point. I'm going to switch to the Sydney theme, which is a very popular theme. I'll go to the front end, do a refresh. And when I scroll down, you can see it right here. It's something similar, the Proudly Powered By. Let's go into Firefox. I'm going to do my refresh. And I'm going to scroll down. You can see it's not my custom one. I'm going to right click. I'm going to view page source. And I'm going to search the page. And this one also starts proudly like that. And here it is. It's right here, and it goes all the way down to where it says by athemes.dot. And remember I said we don't want that bracket slash div, so that's why I'm copying it all the way to the end there. I'm going to copy that into my clipboard, and I'm going to go back in here. I'm going to highlight, and I'm going to paste it and do an update settings. Now, this one might look a little different because it's a different colored background, and I coded in, I think, was that reddish color. So that's the only spot where it might look weird. So I'm going to do a refresh. And there it is. You could see it. So if you're going to have a dark colored background, you might want to change the font color to be something lighter so it's easy to see. Now let me show you what could be done that might break it. So if I go back here, and a better example would be with the primer theme right here. So let me just activate the primer theme. Okay. And so when I go back to the front end, I switch themes and it's different. Now, the copyright that is generated on this theme, and maybe your theme, will have a year. So you see where it says 2016? Well, if it becomes 2017 on January 1st, that string of text is going to change, and that will make it probably revert to the old copyright credits. You're going to need to go in and change it to 2017. Another caveat is right here where it says site name. Well, it's auto-pulling this from what I have configured in WordPress. And so if I change my site name, it's going to break it. So let me show you what I mean by that and how to fix it. So I need to do a refresh, and I need to find that again. So I'm going to go to View Page Source, and I'm going to do a search for copyright. So here is that little bit. Okay, so right here, this could change in 2017. So let me highlight it like that. And I'm going to go back into the Find and Replace and put that in. I'm going to do my update settings. Okay, so now we're back to our custom copyright. But remember I said if the year changes, it might revert to the old copyright, or if I change the site name. Let me show you what happens when I change the site name. So I'm going to go to Settings, and then General, and here's where it has that phrase site name. What if I change this to WP Crafter, like that, and then I saved it. Now when I go here and do a refresh, that string of information changed because this little bit is pulling dynamically from how I have it set in the theme. And this is as well, the year. So when it changes, it's going to revert back. But not to worry, all you have to do is go back into your real-time find and replace and change it. So right here's where it says site name. So if I put that to what I changed the site name to and click on update settings, it's going to match again. And so when I click on refresh, it goes back. So the same thing's going to happen when it turns to 2017 or 18. You're going to have to go back here and change that date from 6 to 7 to 8 or whatever the year might be. Now, this plugin is super powerful. You can use it to change any bit of text on your website. It's not just for changing the footer copyright. If you have an address and you don't know, maybe that address appears on 30 different places on your website, and instead of going into all those places and changing it, you can just go right here and change it. Or if there's something that your theme is using, like say it's a blog post and it says the word tags, and you don't want it to say tags, you might want it to say topics. You can use this to do that as well. There are so many uses for this plugin, and I think you would agree that this is the easiest way to change the footer copyright credit on any WordPress theme. It's the only video you need to watch on this topic. Hey, before you go, I have something for you, and before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video, and if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.